What is going on, guys? I'm Jay Murda. Welcome to another Before You Buy. Today, we're going to be covering Brian Bosworth, middle linebacker, recently released, 93 overall on this guy, LTD. Can only buy him or pull him from a pack, so you cannot earn him through challenges or anything like that. So we're going to cover everything about this guy. Is he worth it? Overall rank, other middle linebackers that you can get if you can't afford this guy. Is he the best overall? We're going to break it all down right now. Let's get down to the nitty gritty. Let's break them down. Roll that transition, Murda. All right, guys, here we are. I am in the auction house. I just did a simple little filter here. It's going to be 92, 93 quality with the middle linebacker. I just want to see the overall prices of 93s. So if you look at Ray Lewis, is only going to be 400K versus Bosworth. His cheapest on the market right now, it's a three quarters of a mil. 750,000, which is, I mean, that's the most expensive middle linebacker on the market, I think. Yeah, that's the most expensive one on the market. So as far as price wise goes, guys, he's gonna be the most expensive right here, right now. But let's break down his stats. Let's take a look at him. Let's compare him with Ray Lewis. I got both Bosworth and Ray Lewis, so I'm gonna head over to my item binder and let's compare the two. Let's head over. All right, guys, here we are. I'm going to compare Ray Lewis to Brian Bosworth. Like I said, I got both these guys, so I can really tell you in-depthly if these guys are worth it or not. Keep in mind that Ray Lewis, that he is powered up, and he does have that brawler on. Bull, I don't know why I said bull. Probably because I saw. Anyways, not the point. So he does have brawler run stuff. I believe Baltimore Ravens. I don't know if I have five or not. I do not. So he does have all this plussed out. I will show you what Brian Bosworth also has plussed out there. To be honest with you folks, these cards are about the same. Now let's look into them here. Speed wise, 89 on Lewis compared to the 88 on Bosworth. Like I said, about the same. The acceleration is 87 on Lewis, 89 on Bosworth, about the same. The strength is exactly the same. Tackling, 95, 93 on Bosworth. Like I said, about the same. Play recognition, 95 on Lewis to the 92 on Bosworth. Block shedding, about the same, guys. 92, 91. Hit power, 95 on Ray Lewis, but a 91 on Brian Bosworth is actually still going to be pretty damn good. If it's above 90 on hit power, folks, that's pretty damn good. And zone coverage, like I said, they're the same. I mean, 69 on Ray Lewis and 67 on Bosworth. As far as height goes, I mean, they're, like I said, these guys are like almost the same cards. It's weird. Lewis is 6'1, Bosworth is 6'2. I don't know what they weigh, but they look like they weigh about the same. Even their numbers, folks, are only three off. You got 52 on Lewis, 55 on Bosworth here. I'm surprised I didn't play on the same goddamn team. Holy shit. Anyways, let's look at Brian Bosworth powered up, and then you're going to see Ray Lewis not powered up here. But their stats are identical because I took pictures of both of them powered up, and they're like scary identical. So you look at the speed, if you remember, their speed is 89 match, their acceleration is 88 match, their strength, Bosworth, I believe, has a plus one on that, so he has 90 compared to the 89 on Lewis. Tackling, they're almost identical. Play recognition, they're identical. Block shedding, I believe Lewis has like a 91 or a 92, so they're identical. Hit power, Lewis has a 95 to the 93 on Bosworth, identical. And then zone coverage, he does have 69. Lewis does have 69, which is two better than the 67 on Bosworth. So overall, folks, these are probably the best two middle linebackers in the game. And Bosworth costs 750,000. Ray Lewis costs 400,000. Right now, I would get Ray Lewis if you only can afford one of these guys. Obviously, a lot of you might not be able to get the 750,000 Brian Bosworth. These two do complement each other very well in the backfield, meaning when you have both of them out there, it is very special. And I mean, these guys, their hit power is insane. So if they make any tackles and you hit stick anyone, I mean, they're going to fumble probably They're going to force fumbles like 30 to 40% of the time with how Madden is right now and fumbling. So, excuse me. So their hit power is absolutely insane. And when they're both in the backfield, both in the middle, I got to take some water. I got to take a sip of water here. Jesus. Throat's a little parched. Excuse me. But anyways, when they're both back there, it is absolutely insane how good they are. I've been playing, I played like 10 to 15 games with them now, and they're incredible. So I would recommend both of them. But if you can only get one, I would get Ray Lewis for the $400,000 just because he is way cheaper, almost half the price of Brian Bosworth. And their stats are identical, folks. They're literally scary identical. So I would prefer, I would recommend you guys getting Ray Lewis. If you can get Brian Bosworth, get him immediately because he is worth it. All right, guys, this is going to be the full stat breakdown of Brian Bosworth. This is with his run-stopping build. I have run-stopping maxed out with 30 attributes, so it's maxed out completely. And then I do have Brawler on him as well. And the Seahawks, I don't believe I have any power-ups for the Seahawks, but he is fully powered up here too, Brian Bosworth, keep in mind. But this is the full stat breakdown on a 95, Brian Bosworth. Strength, you see him on a 90. Agility, 86. Speed, 89. Not bad there for the top four here. Speed and acceleration, 89, 88. Strength, 90. That's pretty good. Awareness, 92. Like I said, scary. Identical to Ray Lewis at 93. These cards are like identical. Besides the catching and carrying, Ray Lewis is like 10 better on each, which doesn't make that much of a difference. As far as tackling goes, he's 95 tackling. Jumping, 86, which I did not know that guy could jump, but he can jump significantly better than Ray Lewis. We take a look at some other attributes here. Impact blocking, 93. Okay. Block shedding, we've looked at this. Pursuit, 94. I'm about the same as Ray Lewis here. Play recognition, 94. Man coverage, he's terrible. 56. Stamina, 92. Ray Lewis, 94. I mean, it's above 90, folks, so it's going to be pretty damn good anyways. As far as that goes, I think is there one more at the end? Nope. Yeah, his full stat breakdown is literally identical to Ray Lewis. And he's like double the price as Ray Lewis. But that's the full stat breakdown on Brian Bosworth. Let's go ahead and look at the market. If you can't afford either of these guys, let's see who you maybe can get for not bad stat-wise. Let's take a peek at the auction house, see what they got. All right, guys, here we are at the auction house. If you cannot get Ray Lewis or Brian Bosworth, we're going to take a peek at the 90 to 91 tier range and just kind of see who's going to be the best to get in this overall, 90 to 91 overall for a middle linebacker. This is if you cannot afford Ray Lewis or Brian Bosworth. If you can, you get those two immediately and you put them back there. Ryan Shazier as your captain, put him as your third string. You're good to go. That's my setup personally. But anyways, let's take a look at the 90 to 91s. Now, I've actually ran with a lot of these guys, so I really don't have to go into the stats. I can kind of tell you who's going to be the best to use just because I've had almost all these guys. Just scrolling through, I'll show you who I've had. I've had Luke Kuechly. I had him for like the first quarter when I played Madden. I actually pulled him in a pack. He was amazing. The dude's absolutely amazing, but there are way better middle linebackers out there. He was just amazing when the game first released. So as far as right now goes, I did have Mosley as well. These two are about the same, but I would prefer Kuechly over Mosley. Mosley's going to be a little bit more expensive usually. Obviously, only right here, it's only 9K, but if you can, folks, I did do a before you buy on Brian Urlacher. He's a very good card. So I would recommend Brian Urlacher as one of your middle linebackers. If you can't afford Ray Lewis or Brian Bosworth, then get Brian Urlacher as one of your middle linebackers. And as far as your second goes, it kind of depends how much money can you spend here. I had Willie Lanier. Don't know if I'm pronouncing that right, but I had him and he wasn't bad at all. I mean, he was solid, but I would recommend Patrick Willis if you can afford it. But Patrick Willis is going to be like, I'm selling my Patrick Willis right now. And he's going to be just about as expensive as Ray Lewis. So I would end up getting Ray Lewis, but Patrick Willis is a very good, very, very, very good middle linebacker. But he's just so damn expensive for a 91 overall. You can get a 93, 92 overall for that kind of money. So as far as the 90 to 91 goes, if I had to pick two of these guys to put on my team, I would pick Brian Urlacher. And then I would probably go with the Chiefs 91, Willie Lanier, if I had to pick two of these guys. Brian Urlacher has some pretty good stats here, guys. Speed and acceleration-wise, he is only 85-85, but you can power him up, and then you can put the speedster on him, or you can put brawler on him, whatever you want. If you want the strength or if you want the speed, depending on what you want. But he has very good zone coverage, so he's very good. If you look at his zone coverage, he's like almost almost 20 better than Brian Bosworth. With a power up and everything, he would be 20 better. So he's very good cover guy. He's just not the fastest, but that's what you get for a 91. But I would recommend those two guys overall. But let's go ahead and rank Brian Bosworth. And let's see, overall, is he worth it or not? What's his overall rank? Should you be getting this guy right now? Or should you be waiting on this guy? Is something else going to pop up in the harvest later this month? Let's roll that transition and let's break it down. All right, guys, here we are. We are going to rank Brian Bosworth. Is he worth it? Should you get the guy? And what's his overall rank personally for me? What would I rank him? What would Murder rank him? So let's start with the rank. Let's start with the juicy material first. Overall, I would rank Brian Bosworth 8 out of 10. 8 out of 10. 8 out of 10. I would give him an 8 out of 10 just because he is so expensive right now. Maybe he will drop later in the month when they release their harvest packs and all the good stuff for Thanksgiving. Barry Sanders is probably coming, so on and so forth. But right now, he is so damn expensive. And you can get Ray Lewis for almost half the price, probably 75% to 80% less than you can get Brian Bosworth. And overall, he's a great card. That's why he gets an 8 out of 10, but he's just expensive. So I would recommend him, yes. Is he worth it? That's a hard question because prices are going down on these cards. So I think he will be worth it very soon as far as right now goes. If you can't afford him, just wait on him. He'll go down to 500K at some point. They'll release someone else and he'll be affordable for you. And then you can have Ray Lewis and Brian Bosworth as your two middle linebackers with Ryan Shazier as your captain at a 93 overall as your third string. So you'll be set at middle linebackers. Like I said, that's my personal lineup for middle linebackers. And that's what I would recommend. Just an overview again, guys, if you can't afford these two guys being Ray Lewis or Brian Bosworth, the 90 to 91s, I would go Brian Urlacher as your first, and it kind of depends what you can spend on your second middle linebacker, but I would get Willie Lanier, the Chiefs middle linebacker. He's also a 91 series Reddix, I believe it is. If you can't afford him, maybe you can get Luke Kuechly or CJ Mosley. Those guys are going to be a little bit cheaper than Willie, but again, it's all a matter of how much money are you going to spend. Which one slogan I kind of follow is, are you going to buy it nice or do you want to buy it twice? Meaning, do you want to get, you know, you can get a Luke Kuechly, but if you get that Willie Lanier, you know, that Willie Lanier is going to be way better than Kuechly, and at some point you're going to get rid of Kuechly to get a better middle linebacker, so you have to technically buy it twice just to get that one nice thing, if you see what I'm saying, rather than just buying one thing really, really nice and then you don't have to buy another thing for, let's say, another month or maybe even longer than that. He could be really good and you keep him on your team for 2 months. I don't know. That's all personal preference. But that's all I got for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed the Before You Buys. If you do, please like the video down below. I appreciate any comments you guys have. I respond back right away. If you have any questions, put them down below in the comment section and let me know what you're thinking. And as always, guys, peace, love, and happy thoughts. Enjoy the rest of your day or night. And thank you for watching the Before You Buy by Murda. See ya!